गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड यू आर डूइंग वेल. चिल्ड्रन, दिस वीडियो इज इट इज इन कॉन्टिन्यूएशन विद आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वेयर वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स. इन दैट वी हैव सीन द रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज ऑफ मेटल्स, दैट विच एलिमेंट्स आर मोर रिएक्टिव, लेस रिएक्टिव, और which elements they do not react, right? So now today we will see the chemical properties of metals with oxygen. So now the reaction with oxygen, if you will see here, so when metals, if they react with oxygen, they will form metallic oxides, and these metallic oxides are basic in nature, right? The example you can see here, rusting of iron. So following is the reactions to express it. You can see down that how iron, oxygen, water, it's actually showing the moist air here, and they form the iron oxide, Fe2O3. Now how this rusting is taking place? So this actually comes from the property of corrosion. So corrosion, what is corrosion? Corrosions actually, when an iron and many other metals, when it react with oxygen and moisture present in the atmosphere, and this phenomena is called corrosion. So metals actually show the property of corrosiveness or corrosion. So this process, corrosion process, slow eating away of a metal due to the attack of atmospheric gases and moisture on its surface, and we call it as a corrosion. Now if you talk about the rusting of iron, so here the rusting of iron, it takes place like when iron, it reacts with oxygen and moisture present in the atmosphere, it forms a brown flaky substance, and we call it as a rust. As you can see also there on the screen, that how the brown patches or flaky substances are formed, and we call it as a rust. And rusting of these iron is an undesirable reaction because the layer of rust formed falls off when it is exposing to the metal, to further rusting, and as a result iron objects become weak and weak with the passage of time, right? So this is about the reaction of metal iron with oxygen. It forms a rust. Fine. The another example, children, with the oxygen only here, that if you talk about a copper vessel here, if a copper vessel is left open in presence of the moist air, then a dull green coating will be observed on it. You also must have observed a green coating, right? So this material, it is actually a mixture of copper hydroxide. The formula for copper hydroxide is CuOH twice, and copper carbonate. The formula for copper carbonate is CuCO3. Okay, so what happens when this is exposed to the moisture or in presence of atmosphere, right? So the copper objects, it get coated with a green substance, and this is a basic copper carbonate, and with the passage of time this green substance is formed, and due to the reaction of copper with carbon dioxide and moisture present in the atmosphere, it forms copper hydroxide and copper carbonate. The following is the reactions to express it. As you can see that how the copper, it is reacting with carbon dioxide and moisture, water and oxygen, it gives you copper hydroxide and copper carbonate. So copper also, we say it is a metal which gives the green coating or green coating as the iron with the oxygen, right? Iron, they shows the brown flaky substances, and here the copper vessels, when it is exposed, it shows the dull green coating. Fine. So these two, copper and iron, show the property of corrosiveness or corrosion. All right. Now there are few more examples of metals with the oxygen. Here today we are talking with the metals reacting with the oxygens only. So when metals react with oxygen, they form metal oxide. Like I told you earlier also, you can see there also on the screen, metal plus oxygen might give you metal oxide. These metal oxides are basic in nature. Okay, for example, the another example you see here, copper oxygen give you copper oxide. Formula also mentioned down. Cu copper, two molecules of Cu plus oxygen give you two molecules of copper oxide. Aluminium oxygen gives you aluminium oxide. Okay, when aluminium it reacts with oxygen, four molecules of aluminium and three molecules of oxygen will give you two molecules of aluminium oxide, Al2O3. Now there's two molecules, four molecules, this is just a number of molecules to balance the equations. Okay, then you can see there magnesium, when it reacts with the oxygen, it gives you magnesium oxide. So here what happened, children, with magnesium, when they burnt, right, so they burns with a white dazzling flame and forms a white powder, and this is actually a magnesium oxide. Okay, so this magnesium oxide reactions, you can see 2Mg plus O2 gives you magnesium oxide, two molecules of MgO, magnesium oxide, MgO, right? So these are the few reactions of metals with oxygen, right? So quickly we will just see that how the reactivity of these metals differs with the oxygens. Okay, so you can relate this point with the earlier videos reactivity series. All right, now you can see here, for example, if you talk about sodium potassium, it reacts vigorously with air. This is what I've told you, they catch fire when they are kept in open, I mean at room temperature or in air, they catch fire. Okay, so they have to, I mean they are immersed in kerosene to store them. All right, then second, you see the surface of magnesium, aluminium, zinc and lead are covered with a thin layer of oxide to make sure that they do not get oxidized anymore. This is what I've told you there also in reactivity series. While iron does not burn when heated, but iron fillings burn vigorously. Copper surface is coated with a thin layer of black copper oxide to prevent the process of further oxidations from taking place. And gold and silver, they do not react with oxygen. Okay, children, so this is about the chemical property of metals with oxygen. So on the basis of this video, I have made few questions for you all, so you have to write down these answers in your notebook. And one thing, children, the earlier video of reactivity series, that also you have to answer here in this video. So you can see the questions here and relate with the earlier video as well. You have to think and you have to answer. All the answers for these questions are there in the videos. So do hear the videos very carefully. Okay, so we will be meeting with our next video with the another chemical property of metal. All right, till then, keep studying and keep revising. Thank you.